In the day's other news, the U.S. military announced that it knocked a mock warhead out of the sky in the first such test in 3 years. It targeted a long-range missile like one that North Korea is developing. An interceptor launched from Southern California hit the warhead that was launched from more than 4,000 miles away over the Pacific Ocean. South Korea's president charged today that the U.S. delivered more anti-missile launchers to his country without his approval, and he demanded an investigation. Moon Jae-in took office this month after his predecessor was ousted in a corruption scandal. Moon wants to review the decision to deploy the THAAD anti-missile system. Now a spokesman says he was not told about new launchers arriving.
President Moon was briefed on such facts and said it was very shocking. He ordered his senior secretary for civil affairs and the National Security Council chief to find the truth behind the unauthorized entry of the four rocket launchers.
Both China and North Korea strongly oppose South Korea installing the anti-missile system. The death toll in Sri Lanka has hit at least 194 in the wake of severe floods and mudslides. The disaster started last Friday. Today, Indian aid teams offloaded shiploads of goods as rescue efforts continued. Water levels slowly receded as the weather cleared. Almost 100 people are still missing, and more than 80,000 are still displaced and remain in relief camps. Back in this country, the Portland, Oregon man accused of fatally stabbing two other men appeared in court today. Police say the victims intervened as Jeremy Christian was verbally abusing two young Muslim women. The 35-year-old suspect repeatedly shouted to the courtroom during his brief hearing.
Death to the enemies of America. Leave this country if you hate our freedom. You call it terrorism, I call it patriotism. You hear me?
The mayor of Portland says he hopes the killings will lead to changes in the nation's political dialogue. The city of Cleveland has fired the police officer who fatally shot a 12-year-old black boy, Tamir Rice. Officer Timothy Lohman shot Rice at a recreation center in 2014. It happened moments after Lohman and another officer answered a call about someone pointing a gun. It turned out Rice had a pellet gun. Cleveland's police chief says that Lohman was fired for inaccurate details on his job application and not for the Rice shooting itself.
There's a 12-year-old kid dead. So, I mean, you know, people on both sides are going to say it wasn't enough, it was too much. After, you know, over 2 years of investigation by our agency, the county prosecutor's office, the sheriff's department, I think we've come to what we consider a fair conclusion to this process.
Lohman's partner on the force was suspended for 10 days for a driving violation. Meanwhile, five people are dead and 44 wounded in Chicago after a wave of shootings over the Memorial Day weekend. The holiday has become one of the deadliest times of the year in the city. This year's numbers are actually lower than last year, when seven people were killed and 61 wounded. Police in Florida now confirm that golfing great Tiger Woods had not been drinking when they arrested him early Monday. A police report confirms Woods' statement that alcohol was not involved. It does say the golfer was, quote, asleep at the wheel, and that his speech was, quote, extremely slow and slurred. Woods is still facing a charge of driving under the influence. He blames a reaction to medication. On Wall Street, a seven-day rally ended as interest rates fell and pulled down bank stocks. The Dow Jones Industrial Average lost 50 points to close at 21,029. The NASDAQ fell 7 and the S&P 500 slipped about 3. And former Panamanian dictator Manuel Noriega died in Panama City today. He grabbed power in the early 1980s and initially became a U.S. ally. But a U.S. invasion ousted him in 1989, and he served 17 years in a U.S. federal prison for drug trafficking and money laundering. He later served time in France and back in Panama as well. Manuel Noriega was 83 years old.